Gas. It's in your car.
And it's in your butt.
And it's on my mind. All right, let's light some stuff on fire.
Ha! This is cars down to the atom.
Gasoline. Turns out it's not just for huffing and getting high. It's also for your cars, lawnmowers, leaf blowers. It's so good at what it does that it powers almost anything with a motor. But what is it? Gasoline comes from petroleum oil, which comes from organisms breaking down over millions of years. In the mid-1800s, people began trying to separate it out, get rid of all the crap, to refine it. Now, we have all kinds of liquids and oils that come from petroleum, and they burn really, really well. Starting with just the name. It sounds like a chemical. Gasoline is actually a mix of a ton of different chemicals, all really good at burning. Its name, gasoline, it's made up. To sell this new fuel, they combined the word gas, which people knew could be fuel, like in their gas lamps, with the suffix ol, which sounded like oil, and then they rounded it off with ene, which made it sound chemical-y. In English, they call it petrol, because it comes from petroleum oil. We just arbitrarily named it gasoline. Here's basically how an engine works. Air comes in the shaft, and it gets mixed in with the gas, and then it's compressed by this piston. When it's right at the top, a spark ignites, and boom, drives the piston down, and that drives the engine. In the explosion, gas combines with the oxygen to give off energy. 1 gallon of gas combines with 20 pounds of oxygen. That is a lot of air. It creates a lot of power. It also makes 18 pounds of carbon dioxide and 8.5 pounds of water. You ever notice water coming out of a tailpipe when the engine's running? Well, that's because water is a byproduct of all those tiny little explosions going on in the engine. This is a 5 gallon jug. There's air in there, which means there's oxygen in there, just like there's oxygen out here. I did the math, and there should be enough oxygen to burn up about 2 tablespoons of gasoline.
What a coincidence. I happen to have 2 tablespoons of gasoline right here.
All we need to combine the oxygen in the jug with the gasoline is a spark. James is gonna act as our fuel injector.
I'm a fuel injector.
This is gonna be like the cylinder in your car, and I've rigged up this ignition coil to give us a spark. Don't do this at home, because it's stupid.
Yeah, do it at work.
Woo! That was fun, huh? You guys see how scared James was? What happened to the jug is a little bit different than what happens in your engine. Because in your engine, the air's under compression. And compressing air makes for a different challenge. Air is a bunch of molecules all rubbing against each other. And when the air gets compressed, those molecules rub together more. And when they're rubbing together more, they generate heat. So more compression means more heat. In a hot engine, there's a chance that fuel will combust without a spark. And that's called engine pinging, or pre-ignition. And that's bad. If the explosion happens at the wrong time, you're not gonna get the performance you should. The piston and the combustion are working against each other, and you risk damaging your engine. Originally, they fixed it by adding lead to the fuel, because lead made the gas more stable at high temperatures. No more pinging. But we stopped doing that because putting lead in everything is dumb, and it hurts your brain. That's why all the gas at the pumps say unleaded. It's also why paint chips don't taste as good anymore. Guys, what are we doing? Gotta have my chips.
What's with all these numbers on the pump? 87, 89, 91.
Well, that's the octane rating. The higher the octane rating, the more resistant the gas is to pre-igniting.
What the hell is an octane rating?
Octane is a chemical like gas that's super resistant to spontaneous ignition. So we use it as a standard to measure gasoline. The octane rating, that's the number you see at the pump, is not how much octane is in the gas. It's just how well the gasoline mixture resists ignition under pressure compared to octane. For example, 87 octane is 87% as good as octane, at reducing pre-ignition. So that's why high-performance cars with turbochargers and high-compression engines gotta make sure they use high-octane gas so it doesn't combust early under all that added pressure.
Is higher octane gas better for my engine?
Not necessarily.
Will higher octane gas help clean my engine?
No! Higher octane gas will not ignite until it's supposed to. That's what it means. If you don't drive a car that needs higher octane gas, well, you're better off using 87 like the rest of us peasants. So it started as rotten, ancient bug juice, and we've refined petroleum into this miracle fuel that drives almost everything. So now you know a little bit more about gasoline, what it is, how it works, and what all that stuff at the pump means.
You blow something else up?
Yeah.
It's used ethanol. The longer we wait, the bigger it'll be.
This is ethanol.
You put it in gas.
You also put it in your belly.
Gets you crunk.
Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. I had a blast. I'm gonna be doing this every week. We're gonna talk about the nitty-gritty about cars, how they work, what's in them. I wanna know what you guys wanna know. Tell me what you guys wanna see us blow up. What you guys would like to see cut in half. What do things look like in the inside? I need an excuse to do stupid stuff. Give me an excuse. Let's get into it together. Let's find out how cars work. Don't tell my wife I did this. I'll see you guys next week.